Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to our Standing Watch program. The recent deadly Israeli attack on a flotilla heading towards the Gaza Strip has resulted in worldwide condemnation of the State of Israel and the Israeli government. And even though the facts aren't entirely clear as to what actually happened, the point I'd like to stress today is that Israel has been the country which has been attacked. And in order to show you how much this condemnation has been, I'd like to read to you from some articles published in the German press. First of all, here's an article by Der Spiegel Online, dated May 31, saying, in addition to the human tragedy, it is also a political catastrophe for Israel. It has provided its critics around the world with fresh ammunition. It goes on to say that in times of crises, Israel seems to search for opportunities to turn the world against it. I'd like to read to you from the very conservative and pro-Israeli German paper Die Welt. And even they had this to say. Everyone knew that Israel could only look bad if it followed a course of confrontation with these haters of Israel, disguised as peace activists. That is why it's even less understandable that no effective precautions were made to prevent such a catastrophe. Now, that's pretty mild in comparison to some of the other newspapers. Here's one from the Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung, dated May 31. It says, the current Israeli government appears to have lost any sense of proportion in the implementation of its Gaza blockade, and it has already shown that it doesn't care one iota about public opinion. Israel's international standing will be further diminished. And then listen to this one by the center-left Süddeutsche Zeitung, also dated May 31. Israeli forces have now caused the worst possible damage to its standing in the world. And here's one from the Business Daily Handelsblatt. It has isolated Israel in the world. And here a very strong comment by the left-leaning Tageszeitung, also dated May 31. It says, what happened at dawn on Monday in the Mediterranean Sea was a targeted attack on a civilian ship in international waters. The term of that is state terrorism. There's another interesting statement by Die Zeit, another very popular and influential article or magazine, I should say, in Germany, and this is what it was stated on June 7. Israel is a country that is increasingly acting as if it were in a separate moral world, pressured by the feeling of being alone, and as a result, believing itself to be empowered to commit arbitrary attacks. And then there is this article again by Der Spiegel Online, dated June 7. Israel is becoming increasingly isolated politically. But you see, the critics have also summoned their opinions and have published them in Israel itself. Here is an article by the Israeli paper Haaretz, dated May 31, saying, despite having its eyes wide open, Israel fell into a trap. Israel knew that the organizers of the flotilla wanted to present the Israel Defense Forces to the world as an army that doesn't hesitate to use force. The flotilla organizers wanted death, casualties, blood, and billows of smoke. And this is exactly what Israel gave them. It's hard to understand how stupid and tragic it was. Over and over, the policies of force fail. The problem is that with each failure, the part of the world which we would like to belong to is losing patience with us. And that is very, very correct. Now, the same paper also wrote an article a little later on June 10, stating that it appears that Turkey's prime minister was behind this whole flotilla endeavor, and that he was fully prepared and anticipated an attack of Israel on the ship. And Turkey has played a very dubious role in this entire matter, as you will perhaps have heard. The prime minister also said that he himself may want to go to Gaza, and also that he is prepared to have the Turkish Navy participate and accompany future flotillas. Of course, Iran just stepped in too and made their will known that they are willing to support militarily future ships. You also probably have heard about the UN resolution to impose further quote-unquote sanctions against Iran. I say sanctions in quote because it's really not meaningful sanctions at all due to Russia's and China's objection, so they kind of renegotiated those. But even those little quote-unquote movements were objected to by, amongst others, Turkey. We find in the Bible that Turkey will play an important role in the end time against Israel, but in cooperation with Europe. And we also find, interestingly enough, in the book of Zechariah, in the 14th chapter, that all nations will fight against Jerusalem, and even Judah will fight against Jerusalem. We're talking about Jewish groups, Jewish organizations outside the state of Israel, which will actually force a fight and participate in a fight against Jerusalem, believe it or not. It is interesting to me that we hear now about some Jewish organizations who have said they also want to now prepare ships to go into the Gaza Strip, obviously with the goal to provoke the Israeli government in one way or another. What we are seeing right now in the Middle East is that obviously this powder keg will explode pretty soon. Israel is being pushed in a corner and they will retaliate. They will not be pushed much longer. They will do something. The more you push them, the more they will react. Now, we are not here to take any positions. We are not here to say that this party is right and this party is wrong. We are here to tell you what is going to happen in the light of biblical prophecies. And the Bible prophesies that in the end time in which we are living, believe it or not, the Middle East will be an area of continuous uproar and fighting, and it's going to be European armies in collaboration with Arab nations which will try to bring quote-unquote peace to the area with military means. And you know, my friends, that that will never work. We will keep you informed about what is happening, because what we have seen right now is just the beginning of further dramatic developments. Thanks very much for watching. This is Norbert Link.